Professor Dr. J. S. Patil, Honorable Vice Chancellor, National Law University and Judicial Academy, Assam, the chief guest of today's function, Mr. Jotin Hajorika, our friend, philosopher and guide, Mrs. Kiran Borguhai, Mrs. Ilora Brahmo, and Dr. Unmana Borguhai, the prime mover, engine behind all this event. And also my esteemed guest sitting in the front row, especially the nursing director from Malar Fortis Hospital. Thank you so much for making it possible from such a long distance. And also my esteemed delegates, speakers, moderators, the faculty from AINE, and also my dear students. It's indeed a momentous occasion to be here in the midst of all of you. There cannot be a more appropriate moment to host this event than what we are today. I have been practicing medicine for last almost 50 years. By remaining ethical, it helps me to have a quiet sleep at night every day. Medical ethics should be the way of our life. It's not that medical profession in one place and medical ethics in another place. We should learn to practice ethical medicine, be it a doctor, be it a nurse, or be it an administrator. This has become more relevant in today's world because of varying geopolitical situations across the globe, because of financial disparities across the globe. There are countries which are spending 17 to 18% of their GDP in healthcare. There are countries who are not able to spend even 1% of the GDP in healthcare. But it is our challenge to remain ethical despite this financial disparity. Not only that, there are also disparities in human resources, distribution of human resources. Healthcare is one human being taking care of another human being. One side of the human being is the patient, then the other side of the human being is the care provider, the doctor, nurse, and the support staff. But there is, again, acute disparities in the distribution of human resources across the globe. There are countries who have got 70 doctors for every 10,000 people. India, we have 13 doctors for every 10,000 people. Come to Northeast, we have only 3 doctors for every 10,000 people. But can we be unethical because of that? We cannot. It is our challenge to remain ethical. I'm happy that the AINE has organized this show, where stakeholders from various fields have come together discussing and debating about how we can remain ethical despite various challenges in front of us. And this 2 days conference will throw enough light on the subject, will inspire many more sitting in this hall to meet those challenges and remain ethical all throughout their professional life. I wish all the success of this conference. Thank you very much.